Hey, I'm Eric Robertson, and in this video, we're going to look at 10 different strategies from Steve Jobs' original iPhone keynote so we can become better presenters ourselves. So let's take a look.
This is a day I've been looking forward to for 2.5 years.
First, start with a date. Notice the way that he starts the presentation and how he uses numbers and a way to mark time in order to start. This is typically a very strong way to start any presentation.
Every once in a while, a revolutionary product comes along that...
Use symbols for emotion. Notice the way that the Apple logo is in the background when he's talking about a new dawn, a new day, a new horizon. These types of symbols can be very powerful for creating emotional appeals.
And Apple has been, well, first of all, one's very fortunate if you get to work on just one of these in your career. Apple's been very fortunate. It's been able to introduce a few of these into the world.
Show gratitude. Notice here how he's talking about how Apple has been fortunate enough. They've been fortunate. So he's trying to show gratitude here to show that they're grateful for the fact that Apple's had previous success.
Been able to introduce a few of these into the world. 1984, we introduced the Macintosh. It didn't just change Apple. It changed the whole computer industry.
Number four is slide timing matters. Notice how each one of these slides is perfectly timed with his voice and the way that he's introducing each item. Notice how it doesn't all show up at the same time, but it shows up just as he's presenting it.
So, three things. A widescreen iPod with touch controls, a revolutionary mobile phone, and a breakthrough internet communications device.
The rule of three. Notice how when he talked about previous Apple products, he used three, so those two and then this new one. And also when he introduced the features of the new iPhone, how those are broken down into three different components. Usually organizing things into rules of three or into three different groups helps them be easier to remember.
It didn't just change the way we all listen to music. It changed the entire music industry. Well, today, we're introducing
transitions. Notice the clear transitions between each one of these points. Sometimes you'll hear him say things like, so today, notice we're moving from one content area to the next.
The first one is a widescreen iPod with touch controls. The second is a revolutionary mobile phone.
Check out how he states words exactly as they show up on the slides. He's not saying any other words because he understands that once something is on the screen, the audience is going to start reading it. So he says the words on the slide exactly as they show up.
So, three things. A widescreen iPod with touch controls, a revolutionary mobile phone, and a breakthrough internet communications device.
Review slides. Notice how after showing each of the iPhone features, he gives a review slide that shows all three at the same time. Recognize the difference where if he were to show that with all three at the beginning, how that would have made a considerable impact on both the focus of all of the people in the audience, as well as the anticipation for each one of those features. So try and keep things to one idea per slide, and then from there you're able to make it so we can do a review and go over everything that's been discussed.
Apple is going to reinvent the phone. And here it is.
Notice in this section of this presentation where he's able to use a slide that already has pre-built-in humor into it. Amy Cuddy's TED Talk actually does this as well when she's showing the different handshakes for nonverbal communication. And this is an opportunity for people who aren't necessarily that funny or people who want to make sure that what comes off is going to be funny, where they have something planned outside of themselves or they know it's going to get a laugh. So Steve Jobs having the funny iPhone, iPod contraption thing, this is an example of this because Steve Jobs by himself isn't usually too funny, but here in this example, you're able to see how he's able to use humor to keep things light and keep things moving.
Now, Actually, here it is, but we're gonna leave it there for now. So.
Tease your audience just a little bit to keep them interested. Notice what he did here when he was able to show the audience quickly the iPhone from his pocket and then put it back in. We didn't get to see it, but we were able to gain interest and tease us. So a lot of times if you have some key information and you give us a little bit, that'll keep us still interested so we stay with you for the entire presentation. This is a really long speech. There's quite a few different areas where he does an amazing job. We just broke down the first couple of minutes to look at some of the strategies that were being employed by Mr. Steve Jobs. Hopefully this was helpful, and now you can take some of these presentations from his keynote and apply them to your speeches. So go out there and deliver something amazing.